In this video, we are going to have a look at the Meike full frame 85mm f2.8 macro lens. Kia ora, good morning everyone, Richard Wong here. Welcome back to the channel. Today we are going to have a look at this Meike macro lens. This is the 85mm f2.8 macro lens for full frame cameras. First of all, a quick disclaimer, Meike sent me this sample for the review, but as usual, they have no control whatsoever on the contents or what I'm going to say in this review. This lens has been available for a little while and for several different months. Optically, the different versions should be all identical. So apart from the mount, they should have the same optical performance. So even though I'm reviewing the Nikon Z mount version in this video, but all the image quality and also the other things like design and build quality, etc., should apply to all the different versions as well. Okay, let's start by talking about design and build quality of this lens first. And just like most other Meike lenses, this lens is pretty much all made of metal. So it feels really solid, especially this part here, the part that near the lens mount, it's super solid. It feels like they are making it with just a big chunk of metal. So the lens is not exactly a lightweight lens. I think the weight of this lens is over 500 grams. So yeah, it is pretty solid lens when you hold it on the hand because of the metal construction. This is a completely mechanical lens. So there is no electronic contacts. There's no autofocus, no auto aperture. There's completely fully manual. The lens comes with a plastic lens hood, which fits onto the lens very nicely. We have the aperture ring at the top here, which is a declicked aperture ring. The ring itself feels very nice, very smooth. And underneath here, we have two rings here, which is something that I found very different and also a bit confusing, especially when I first received the lens, because why a lens that is not a zoom lens has two rings apart from the aperture ring? So turns out what it is that the top ring is like a normal manual focus ring so that you can adjust the focus from infinity to macro, which is the 1x macro here. But if you want to go more than 1x macro, this is something this lens can do. And what you do is you would first still turn the top ring to the closest focus distance, which is the macro focus distance. And then you rotate the other ring, the bottom ring, and now you can go beyond 1x magnification. And as you turn, the lens would extend as well as you are changing from 1x to 1.5x magnification. So definitely quite an unusual design. To be honest, even after shooting with this lens for about 2 weeks, I still find it a bit confusing sometimes, especially when I'm doing some handheld photo when I don't really need to go more than 1x magnification. So normally I shouldn't need to touch this bottom ring because this is only when you need to go beyond 1x magnification. But I still would turn this ring by mistake because when I'm holding the camera and shooting like this through the electronic viewfinder, I'll just grab the ring, and most of the time I grab the right one, but sometimes I grab the wrong one and I just start turning it, and I was wondering why I couldn't get it in focus, and turns out it's because I'm changing this ring. So yeah, I think this is something that you probably would get used to more and more as you using this lens for a longer time. But I hope they could have made it a slightly different design. For example, maybe change these two rings, like make them a little bit more apart so they are not like right next to each other, or maybe have a lock or something on the this bottom ring so that normally when you don't want to go beyond 1x, they could just lock it so you wouldn't turn it by mistake. But yeah, definitely one thing that you have to be careful, and you may find it a bit confusing when you first start shooting with this lens. The travel flow of this focus ring is just over 90 degrees, so it is not particularly long for a macro lens. The ring itself feels quite smooth when you're trying to turn it, but it does feel a little bit stiffer than most other manual focus lenses. And I also can hear a bit of noise when I'm trying to change the focus. Not too sure if it's just something for this particular sample. So if you also have this Makey 85mm lens or you have used one before, let me know whether you also hear the noise when you are turning the focus ring or not. It is not a very loud noise, but it's just something that you will hear when you are shooting in a reasonably quiet room. Like here, I can definitely hear it when I'm trying to turn the focus ring. I have to say, I find the focus ring on this Makey lens a bit harder to use compared to most other manual focus lenses, and there are two reasons. The first one is, as I mentioned just before, the manual focus ring itself is a little bit stiff, which make it a bit harder to do some very fine adjustments, because it takes a bit of effort to move it, and then it's quite hard to move it by just a little bit. And the second thing is, if you want to use this lens to shoot some non-macro photos, because the travel distance between the 1 meter mark and infinity mark is only a very small amount, so that makes it quite tricky when you want to adjust the focus between 1 meter and infinity. And also the fact that the focus ring, if you turn it all the way, it actually goes a little bit beyond infinity. So all this together make this lens a little bit harder to focus when your subject is a couple of meters away. When you are shooting macro photos, then this is not that much a problem, because the travel near the macro focus distance is a lot longer, so it is a lot easier to control when you are shooting macro photos. When you are taking macro photos at 1x magnification, the distance from the front of the lens to your subject is about 12 centimeters. And when you are taking macro photos at 1.5x magnification, the distance from the front of the lens to your subject is now about 10 centimeters. So you probably want to remove the lens hood when you are taking macro photos. But apart from that, the working distance is not too bad with this 85mm macro lens. Okay, let's talk about the image quality and start from the image sharpness first. When you are taking non-macro photos, the center sharpness is already very good at the maximum aperture. And if you look at the corners, the sharpness is also very good at the maximum aperture. Now let's have a look at the image sharpness when taking macro photos a little bit closer. When taking macro photos at 1x magnification, the center sharpness is good at the maximum aperture. Stop down to f4 and then the center sharpness become really good. At 1.5x magnification, at the maximum aperture, the center sharpness does become a little bit softer if you compare to the result you got at 1x magnification. Stop down to f4 would improve the center sharpness quite a bit, but if you stop down to f5.6, then the center sharpness becomes very good as well. Chromatic aberration is very well controlled by this Makey macro lens. When I look at my non-macro photos, even some of those with very high contrast, I see very little amount of chromatic aberration. And let's have a look at these two test photos that I shot at maximum aperture at 1x and 1.5x magnification. There is a little bit of color fringing, but I think overall it is kept at very reasonable level. And let's have a look at this vignetting test photo when I set the lens to infinity focus distance. At maximum aperture, definitely there is quite a bit of light fall off near the edge. When I stop down, the amount of light fall off would decrease, but even when I stop down to f8, you can still see a bit of vignetting at that aperture setting. But one interesting thing is, when I change the focus distance from infinity to the 1x macro focus distance, the amount of vignetting now is greatly reduced. While there is still a bit of venting when I shoot at the maximum aperture f2.8, when I stop down to f4, then venting is not really that noticeable at all. And when I set the lens to 1.5 times magnification, the amount of venting is even less than before, because even when I shoot this test photo at the maximum aperture f2.8, venting is not really that noticeable. So what it means is, if you use this Makey lens to take some long macro photos, you may notice a little bit of vignetting, but if you are taking macro photos with this Makey 85mm macro lens, then you probably won't notice any vignetting at all. This lens has a 12 braid aperture design, and the bokeh is nice and round and smooth, and it doesn't look nervous at all. And even when you stop down the lens, the bokeh still remained quite round and quite smooth. Distortion is also very well controlled by this Makey lens. Even look at these brick wall test photos, you will see very minimal amount of distortion. In some of my previous Makey lens review, I have complained about some of them where the lens flare control is not really quite as good as I want it to be. But with this 85mm macro lens, the lens flare control is actually very good. Even when I'm shooting directly into the sun or some very bright light source, the amount of lens flare and ghosting is kept at a very reasonable level. At only $270, this Makey lens is a very affordable macro lens for your full frame camera. Image quality is pretty good no matter you are shooting macro photos or non-macro photos, or if you want to use it as a portrait lens, the image quality is pretty decent. And the ability to shoot macro photo at higher than 1x magnification definitely make it an even more interesting lens. So the biggest issue I have with this lens is definitely not the image quality, but more the design or the control of this lens. I still find this dual ring control a little bit confusing. Even after using it for 2 weeks, quite often I would turn the wrong ring when I'm taking photos. And also because of the travel distance between the 1 meter and infinity is very tiny, so when you're taking non-macro photos, the adjustment of the focus could be a little bit tricky, especially when you're shooting at the maximum aperture. I do feel as you spend more and more time with this lens, these issues would probably become less and less affecting your shooting experience. But definitely these are things that you need to watch out for, and you probably need to spend a bit of time to overcome these issues if you want to buy and shoot with this otherwise excellent value for money macro lens from Makey.